Now on to the dinosaur of the day, Tyrannotitan. And this is a special request from Cole, who requested it via Facebook. And he specifically requested that we post our episode today because today, January 28th, is his birthday. So happy birthday, Cole. Hope you have an awesome day and you have some time to spend with some dinosaurs. And, you know, friends and family too, but also dinosaurs. So the name Tyrannotitan means tyrant titan. And it was a bipedal carnivore that lived in the early Cretaceous in what is now Argentina. The species name is Tyrannotitan chubutensis, and the species name refers to the Chubut province in Argentina, where the fossils were found. It was described in 2005 by Fernando Novas, Silvina de Valais, Pat Vickers-Rich, and Tom Rich. A fragmentary skull and lower jaw was found, as well as teeth and a partial postcranial skeleton. The holotype also included teeth, back vertebrae, proximal tail vertebrae, ribs, humerus, ulna, a nearly complete femur, fibula, neck vertebrae. So it's a theropod, and it was closely related to Carcharodontosaurus and Giganotosaurus, as well as Mapusaurus. Along with Acrocanthosaurus, it's the oldest known giant carcharodontosaurid in North America. It had small forearms, like a tyrannosaurid, but it was not a tyrannosaurid. We know this because South America, at the time that Tyrannotitan lived, was isolated from North America and Africa. Some scientists think that Tyrannotitan could actually be the same as another carcharodontosaurid from South America, but for now it's considered its own genus. Tyrannotitan was about 40 feet or 12.2 meters long, though Gregory Paul estimated in 2010 that it might have been 43 feet or 13 meters long. It weighed over 6 tons, and it's different from other carcharodontosaurids because of its lack of pneumaticity, which are air spaces and bones, in the hip and tail vertebrae, so it had no air pockets to help reduce its weight. Its teeth were not as developed as other carcharodontosaurids. There were no clear curves to help with slicing, but the shape was similar to the shape of Allosaurus teeth. It had these chisel-like denticles on its teeth. So these denticles had grooves that divided them, which would have helped to tear into flesh. And that's different from other teeth of later dinosaurs that had curved teeth with serrated edges. So they think that maybe Tyrannotitan's teeth were kind of experimental. The teeth, though, were still good for stripping flesh from dead prey, just not as good for crunching bones. In May 2014, it was reported that there was a dinosaur graveyard of huge titanosaurs, along with over 50 Tyrannotitan teeth, on the La Flecha farm in Patagonia, Argentina. If you'd like to see Tyrannotitan, you can see one in the Museum of Paleontology Egidio Fergulio in Patagonia, Argentina. Also, in the Jurassic World Park Builder game, you can create a Tyrannotitan if you want to see a play version.
Just don't pay like $4,000 for it.
Yeah, like the 1 7-year-old boy from the UK. So Tyrannotitan is a carcharodontosaurid, and carcharodontosaurid's name means shark-toothed lizards, and they were carnivorous theropods. Ernst Stromer named the family in 1931, and the family includes Giganotosaurus, Mapusaurus, Carcharodontosaurus, and of course Tyrannotitan. They were all about the same size or larger than T-Rex. And carcharodontosaurids, as well as spinosaurids, were the largest predators in Gondwana in the early and middle Cretaceous.
Yeah, they're basically the South American counterpart to the tyrannosaurids, like Sabrina was saying.